Hey everyone, what's going on? It's Dave Kettner here again with you with another training video. This one is going to be all about changing a PNG or a JPEG into an SVG, doing this on your own, very simply, for free. So this will actually save you some money instead of having to go through Fiverr and trying to have someone do it and making sure you find the right person, or doing it in a more expensive software like Illustrator or even Adobe Express can work sometimes. But with this, it's very simple. I'm gonna show you how to do it. And this would be a conversion if you had a simple image, all right? Something that has maybe six or less colors in it. And I'll show you what I'm talking about as we do a couple examples here. So let me switch over to my computer and show you the site that I'm talking about and how to do this. All right, so this site is called PNG2SVG.com, and I'll put the link in the description below so you guys have access to that. And basically what you're doing here is you see like this example they put here. They're taking this first image, which is an image on a background here, that just a pure background, there's no background, and then they're moving it to a SVG. Now an SVG file allows us to make it into different vectors and allows a machine like Cricut or Silhouette to cut out those specific vectors to be able to print into a t-shirt or something similar than that, or like that, I should say. So we scroll down here, you'll see there's an area that says drag and drop a file. So I actually just put some examples here together. I have it over here. I have a few examples that I did. I'm just going to pull one of these, and let's take this class of 2023. I'm going to move it over here and drop it in. You'll see it'll pull it up right there, class of 2023. Now this is the PNG file, and it is with the background removed. That's what this is here. So I'm gonna click on generate. Now before I do that, you'll see it says it's recognizing that there's five colors right there, and it shows you the palette, and it'll reference to each one. So you'll see that color goes here, this red one goes here, and the black goes there, and you have some different styles. And the brown is somewhere in there. I don't see where the brown is, but I don't see where we have, you know, this color. So we can always add a sixth one, and it's pulling in a gray from somewhere. But I'm actually going to click on this palette, and I'm going to click on here. So then that brings in that tan. So I get those different things. I really don't want to go more than six, because every time we add a different color in here, it's a different cut that has to be done with an SVG file. All right, so for now, let's just do six. So this has six different colors. So I'm gonna click on generate, and it's gonna do its magic. And when it's finished, it's gonna put it over here and see what it looks like. And I'm gonna let that go. And it's coming in right now. It's gonna start doing it right here. And there it goes, it generated the SVG file with those colors. Now you see there's some that are a little bit different. So it didn't bring in that gold here, it brought in the tan. See, it just did a less color. So if I wanna do a seventh color, I could, but here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go over here, I don't see, you know, this gray is probably the hat. I'm okay with that being more black, so I can actually, or even that brown. Where's that brown? I can't really see where the brown's coming in from. So I'm gonna click on that brown, and I'm gonna turn it to this kind of goldish color. All right, so now we have that. I'm gonna hit generate, and let's see how it changes here. All right, there it brought it in. You see, I didn't notice much of a difference with that brown, so I really didn't know where that brown was coming in from, but now I have that gold tassel. All right, so I have the gold tassel with the tan and a little off color. I mean, I can even make that all the same color, but that's okay. We have six, right? And we have the red in there. So now this is the SVG the way I want it with all the colors. So it takes a little bit of manual work to go through when you have multiple colors, but I'm good with that. So I'm gonna hit download SVG right now. And by the way, this is for free, but if you wanna donate, you can put gifts in here, and this is how the person makes money. So it brings it up right there, image vector two, and it's saving it to my downloads. So next what I wanna do is I wanna test this SVG out and make sure that it works. Now I did a whole video on this, make sure you check in my videos. You'll see the training that I go through and show you how to test out an SVG, but I'm gonna show you real fast. And the way we check this out is we bring in a software called Cricut Design Space. It's free. Again, I cover it in my other video of how to download it. I will put a link in the description if you haven't downloaded it to your computer before. It's free to put up there and test out what I'm gonna be showing you here. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna open my Cricut Design Space right now. And here it is right here. I'm gonna go to new project. So what I wanna do is come over here, the bottom left, it says upload, click on that. And then you wanna go to upload an image. So upload image. And I wanna find that file that I just brought in when I downloaded that, which was in my downloads file. So I can actually go over here to download, and I'm going to browse to find it, and I have it right here, so I'm just going to move it over here, drop it in, and it'll bring it into Cricut Design Space. All right, and there it is. You see the file that I just did there, and it looks good there. We want to make sure, though, it looks good in Cricut, so I'm going to click on here to upload at the bottom right, and is going to bring it here in there. Now, the next thing I want to do is I want to bring this in. So I click on it there. I want to add it to Canvas, bottom right-hand corner here, add to Canvas. And it's going to bring it in here. And we're going to see that there it is. And we're going to see the six vectors that we did, the six different colors. We know now that it works. And if I go to make it top right, it'll actually be exactly the way we want. Now I'm going to do it here on mat. Doesn't matter where I push. I just want to confirm that it is working, that the file works good. And as we have it all there, you see we have our cut file for one, our cut file for two. All these is the cut files for each color, and that's exactly the way it's supposed to work. So that is working. So I'm going to cancel that, and I'm going to just delete that, and let's here do another one. So I'm going to come over here and scroll back up to where it says drag and drop a file. And I'll bring this over here again. You see I got some different ones here. Let's try this one here. This is a mother one. So I'm going to move this one over here, drop it in, and there it is. It says, ah, finally coffee, the mom awakens. All right. So as you see, this is very simple. This is just, you know, black and white. In fact, up here it has the palette of all these same colors. All we want to do here is reduce this down to one color. It's all we need is the black one for this. So this is a very simple one to convert to an SVG. I'm going to then come over here to generate, and then it's going to overwrite what we had before and put this one in as an SVG. And there we have it, SVG, download the SVG, and then there you go, have it right there. I can then come back to Cricut just to make sure it worked good. I'm going to go to upload, upload image, browse for it, and in my downloads, there it is, the one I just did. And there it is. So I'm going to test it out by uploading it here. It looks good there. We click on it, add it to Canvas, and see what it looks like in here. It should just be the one vector file. Perfect. And if you're not sure, you want to make sure that it all aligns right. You come over to make it, and I know this is going to work fine because we did it ourselves. Just confirm to do there, and there you go. There's your cut. Okay, this is how we're making sure that these work. We can check it in Design Space, which I did a whole video on this. Again, you can look back at my video training. It was a really good video to come in here and utilize Cricut Design Space to make sure your SVGs are working. All right, so I'm gonna cancel that, and we're gonna do one more here. So I'm gonna delete that. I'm gonna go back to here, and again, I had a few of these together. So let's do one that has a few more colors. I'm gonna grab this best mom here, and I did in the wrong spot. I have to come back over here, drag and drop to there. Or you can always click here to choose the file, but I just drag and drop into there. And then it should bring it in, which it did not yet. Let me try that again. Drop it. There we go. Best mom, hands down. So you see we have one, two colors here. So if I go to the second color, it'll bring in that, you know, that pinkish color that's there. If you went to three, it's going to duplicate. Right, so I'm just going to do it to two, hit generate. Again, a nice easy PNG file here to turn it to an SVG, and then it'll show up here on the right. And there it is, best mom hands down, looks the way we want. You download it, it comes in right there. And then we want to come back over to Cricut Design Space and just test it out. Always test it out. It's better. It's a good thing to do. A good practice. Come in here and browse for it. There it is, the vector. And you want to name these. Make sure you put them what they are. That's it. Upload it to Design Space. We want to then add it to a canvas. It's going to bring it in right here. And there you go. It has the two vectors. We make it. It's going to be exactly the way we want. So this is an excellent way to do easy SVG files. So I mean, if you have colors that are more than six, it makes it more difficult. But we can utilize this site here, pngtosvg.com, to easily turn our JPEGs and PNG files to an SVG and to make sure it's working correctly. So this is a free way you can do it. Again, if you have a complicated one with lots of colors and all that, you will have to pick your color palette and make sure that it is each one correctly. But this is an easy way to freely go ahead and pick out your colors and do the SVG files yourself and not have to worry about paying anyone, and then test it with Cricut Design Space to make sure it's working correctly. So hope you enjoy that. If you did, please give me a thumbs up for this video. And if you enjoy my videos, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. And then click that bell notification. You'll be notified whenever we have new videos, and I put this free training out there for you. So again, hope you enjoyed it, and I look forward to catching you in more trainings in the future. Take care.